Hello, I'd like to show you a method I use to collect work from my students on a blog. We use Google Blogger to do that, and it's a great way to collect work in one place and make online learning easy. The great thing about a blog is that it contains all the work that a student does for my class and also creates a portfolio as they work. Here's an example of a student blog. Each one of these are posts. And so as you can see, there are many different posts here. They're dated here. I require my students to create a weekly blog post. It's due Sunday night and they have to do independent investigations, but this can be modified to weekly work assignments and be collected in one place, as opposed to dealing with a lot of files in a lot of different places. So I've been using this process for about 10 years. I think that it's a wonderful way to collect a lot of work and to be able to hold it all in one place. And the students are, it's very easy for the students to follow. What they do is they go and they, once they publish their blog post, they go and this is the post itself within the blog. And this one just happens to have no writing, although there's a large script because it was for a film student who wrote a script and a storyboard. What they do is they go up here to this URL here, and they go and they copy that, and then they go over into Schoology and they turn it in here as a link. For me, this is the way that it appears, and I just go and click on that link and it takes me right to that blog post. I don't have to search through their blog. And I can take a look at their work and then I can put a grade on it. So the other great thing about this is it creates an archive. So if I go over here as well and find the archive, every blog in Google Blogger has an archive. You can go through and you can see that this student, for instance, has made 4 posts in March. And in February, there were 4 posts as well. Well, that took me right to February, but there is a lot more. If I go down to show more, this is a student that I've had for multiple years, and you can see all the posts he made in 2019, starting with this school year and the previous school year, and working backwards into 2018 and 2017. For an art teacher like myself who teaches film, video, and animation, this is a wonderful way to collect work all in one place that the students can take for a portfolio when they leave school. One more example from another film student here. This is an outstanding student. And you can see that these are the 2020 posts that she's made. These are the ones from 2019. This is a senior student whom I've had in class for 4 years. And as I work my way down, you can see that she was posting back in 2016. I'm making this tutorial in March of 2020 as we transition to online learning. I got this from the this idea from the IB model. From the International Baccalaureate model. In the art classes, they have students create workbooks where they do independent investigations. So, for instance, my students, this student was looking for how to do a, this is an introduction page here. She's writing about, the theme that she's going to look at for the year, kind of getting together all of her planning, and all of that is there. So, I encourage them to include images and also videos.